Get ready to match the stars. From Mork and Mindy, Bob Donner. Fred Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Former Miss World, Marjorie Wallace. Bill Daly. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Raver.
Okay, are you all ready out there? All set? All set up here?
Sure, you bet.
All right?
You bet.
Let me just see how the world looks. Bob Donner. Oh.
Hey, you look good.
Great flannel. Nice. My favorite. Yeah.
It goes with the suit, too.
Yes. Okay.
You got my heart.
Oh, ooh. Ouch. Anything for
you'll never work again?
Yeah, let's carry on.
And let's say hello to Monty Hill and Daphne Davis. Yeah. Applause, applause. Monty Hill, you remember? He's a fellow who's nervous. What do you got to say for yourself, Monty?
Well, I'm not nervous today, Gene. I got some sleep, and I'm going to get some competition in here.
All right. All right. And Daphne, you remember, is a student at USC studying broadcast arts?
Journalism.
Journalism, yeah. Wants to be an anchor person. When will you graduate?
2 years.
2 years.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Someone 2 years hence. There's an attractive young lady who is going to be well-trained and will be applying for a job. Let's go to round two here. That is the final round of the final game. It's all over. Daphne, you're ahead. You go first.
I'll take B.
B it is for you. B says, Frank said, I call my wife Big Red. I call her Big Red because she has a big red blank. All right, Daphne. Frank said, I call my wife Big Red because she has a big red blank.
Nose.
Nose. Good. Gave a perfectly reasonable answer.
Yeah, I threw out my other answer. Irish setter. She has a big red eye.
They're rough.
Enough.
They're mean little buggers, aren't they?
Yep.
The correct answer, Uncle James.
No, it is. All right.
Thank you.
Marjorie, call me what? Big red what? You don't like your answer. I can tell by the look on your face. She won't even say it. I hope you saw it, because I'm not going to say it. Bill doesn't play, we come to Marcia.
Shocking.
Shocking is right.
And I wish I'd thought of it. Nose.
Nose it is. Four for her. Fat Frida is really fat.
How fat is she?
Fat Frida.
She's really fat. Well, no wonder she's fat. Instead of gargling with mouthwash, she gargles with blank. All right, we're about ready now. Monty Hill. Fat Frida is really fat, and no wonder she's fat. Instead of gargling with mouthwash, she gargles with blank.
Beer.
Beer. Unlikely that you're going to find four beers over here, but let's try.
But it's a good answer.
Yes.
Well, let's get off on the wrong foot, shall we? Lots of food.
Food. Gargles with food. All right, Brett.
Oh, be nice. Oh, darling, don't ruin. He doesn't know any better. No! Dean Martin gargles with beer.
Oh.
Fat Frida gargles with melted Hershey bars with almonds.
Oh, dear. Oh. How to match everybody else, Monty, to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
Milkshakes.
Milkshakes. That'll make you fat, so that means definitely wins the game. What the rest of you have?
Heavy cream,
malted milk, and shakes. Come on down back here. All right. Monty, you didn't win any money, but we're going to send you some gifts. We have a mohair straitjacket for you, a canker sore, and all kinds of other wonderful things for Monty Hill.
Thank you.
Say goodbye to Monty. Hello there. Ready, Daphne? Now, you've been up here before. You know how this goes. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank wafer. You remember, it's 500 for the most popular, 250 for the second, and 100 for the third. All right. Whom do you want? Blank wafer.
Bill.
Bill?
I was flirting with you. I didn't know the answer. I was...
Oh.
Vanilla wafer.
Vanilla wafer. You got one, Marcia?
Well, what about Nabisco wafer?
Nabisco wafer.
Obviously not. Well,
it's the best you can offer. That's fine.
That's it, hon.
Yeah, there are Nabisco wafers.
Charles.
How about this?
What?
No, James.
Sugar wafer.
Yes.
So you have sugar wafer, Nabisco wafer, and a vanilla wafer. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
Well, I first thought of vanilla wafer, so I'll say that.
You won't say that?
No, I'd say that.
Hey. Vanilla wafer.
You got it. Let's see if we have a vanilla wafer under the $100 number. You have a chocolate wafer there.
Yummies, I like those too.
Yeah, well, maybe vanilla. If chocolate's there, vanilla can be far behind, can't it? All right, let's take a look at the next one, please.
Oh, boy, Charles.
Oh, Tom said that. I'll take your $5 back.
Oh, good grief.
I hope Patty Duke saw that.
Patty Duke asked, and are you watching? Was that acting? Lee Strasberg, was that acting? No?
Oh, no.
Oh, all right, thank you. All right, let's take a look at the $500 response. Vanilla wafer. Yeah.
Give me a drink. More hot towels, please.
What a crush.
Would you sign this, please?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Anything else we can do for you, Bill?
Newscaster, huh? Okay.
Yeah. Newscaster, right. You know where to get your first job.
Yes.
All right. We'll go to the rest of this game, the big money part of it, in a moment or so, but right now we want to do a little business with the man. All right? All right, thank you very much. Now, here we go. Daphne, you won the $500, means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But remember, you're going to spin the wheel like you did last time? And last time you doubled it up, and now let's see if you can do it again. Here we go. Your lucky day.
Boy, if I win, think I'll really get this time. I'll tell you that.
All right. Face me if you would, please, and good luck to you. It's worth $5,000, and this is it. Glowing blank. G-L-O-W-I-N-G. Glowing blank. You give us the answer that Bill has on the card, and you get $5,000. Daphne, what do you say to that?
Glowing. Flame.
Flame. I thought of something close to that, but I didn't think of flame. Bill, what did you think of?
I really didn't. I said glowing complexion. I'm sorry.
Glowing complexion.
Well, what would be a good answer?
Glowing ember was mine. Glowing ember. What else?
That's a hard one. Glowing worm.
Glowing coals.
Glowing coals.
Coals, yes. Glowing smile. Well, that was close to his, glowing complexion. Now, how much money does she have? $1,000. Congratulations to Daphne Davis. Thank you for being here. Bye. All right, here we got Phyllis Worthy and Kim Otterness. Applause. How do you do, ladies?
Hi there.
Welcome.
Thank you.
We want to get acquainted with you. Kim, let's find out who you are and where you're from and what do you do with your life.
Hi, my name is Kim Otterness. I'm from Illinois, a little subdivision town called Carroll Stream. I'm a realtor. I recently got married, and my husband's out in the audience.
And he's rooting for you.
He sure is.
All right. Good luck to you, Kim.
Thank you.
Phyllis, tell us about you, please.
Well, I'm from Memphis, Tennessee.
Yeah.
And my husband and I are taking a vacation. We started a year ago last September.
Oh.
And we,
long vacation.
Well, we bought a motorhome and we've been traveling all over the gorgeous, beautiful USA.
I did that one year and really loved it.
Oh, it's just been super. And we saved the best for last, coming to Match Game. We're on our way back to Tennessee for Thanksgiving.
Wow. All right. Well, good to have you here, Phyllis. Good luck to you. All right, Kim, you have A or B?
I'd like A, please.
All right, A it is for Kim. A says, Mean Marvin is really mean.
How mean is he?
Well, instead of tying tin cans to the back of the newlywed's car, he tied a blank. Yep. All right. Charles is writing, so I'll read it slowly while he's finishing up. Mean Marvin is really mean. Instead of tying tin cans to the back of the newlywed's car, he tied a blank.
A bomb.
A bomb? That would be mean.
That would be mean.
They'd start driving off, it would bounce around a little bit and go off, and bing, where there they are. They started an early honeymoon. Right.
Well, I thought that Marvin was just a little meaner than that.
Oh.
I said he tied an old boyfriend.
An old boyfriend. Come on the honeymoon, yes. All right.
Now, I'm going on the assumption that if the judges pay strict attention, that this will be inevitably a match.
One never knows.
A hand grenade.
Oh, yes, of course.
Bomb and
a hand grenade.
Yeah. All right,
Charles. I'm going on the assumption that the judges will consider this a match.
Bomb. Mean Marvin really mean. Instead of tin cans, he tied blank to the back of the newlywed's car.
The Marvin I know is very mean. Sick, mean,
a baby.
Terrible.
Oh, a weirdo.
Baby.
A
weirdo.
This girl is Miss World?
Yes.
Oh, her teeth are going to fall right out of her head.
She is a mother of an 18-month-old baby.
That's why she said that.
And she came up with that answer?
Not my son.
Really?
This is kind of semi-mean. This is not really... I tied the maid of honor.
The maid. Future bride-to-be. What did you say, Marcia?
You think it's easy being in this seat?
No, it isn't. This is the toughest seat
in this. It's the toughest seat. And by and large, I do pretty well, don't I?
Yes, you do.
And I thought this was adorable. But, of course, bridesmaid.
Bridesmaid,
yes. See, when he's in maid of honor, then bridesmaid gets nothing. Am I right or what?
Yes.
You probably copied.
Did you copy that answer? No.
I can't read her answers. I can't read my own.
Oh, I see. All right. So she has two, and we'll get to you in a moment or so. Right now, we have this for you. The other round one question is yours, Phyllis. Hey, you may not know this, but...
Well, tell us.
Howard Cosell actually received one fan letter last year.
That's a lie.
No, yes, he did. Unfortunately for Howard, the fan letter was wrapped around a blank. All right, Phyllis. You may not know this, but Howard Cosell actually received one fan letter last year. Unfortunately for Howard, the fan letter was wrapped around a blank.
His toupee.
His toupee?
When I think of Howard Cosell, all I think of is toupee.
Are you sure he wears one? Yes. All right. She says his toupee. Bob, what'd you say?
I didn't say his toupee.
You didn't say that.
I thought bomb was such a great answer before, and I didn't have it. I tried it again.
All right. Good for you. Brett?
Rarely can you use the same answer two times running. Bomb and or hand grenade.
All right. Did that cross your mind, Phyllis?
A bomb?
Yes.
Mm-mm.
No?
It would if you felt the way Gene Rayburn feels about Howard Cosell.
Dead fish.
Aha. Oh. Getting some wonderful answers here, Phyllis.
Oh.
Unfortunately for Howard, the fan letter was wrapped around a...
A bomb.
A bomba.
All another right. Bomb here. We're bombing out, gang.
Another bomb? That's...
Speak for yourself, mister. Sorry, just speak for yourself. He says we're bombing out.
You're not, are you?
Not me, Cookie. Toupee!
Thank you, Marcia.
Well, of course, Phyllis.
And I love your shoulders.
Thank you, hon. That's from the mail. Remember, I got a lot of mail about my shoulders. Cover them up.
Right.
Oh, otherwise, you'll think there's something funny going on with this.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Now,
it's not exactly a stampede, is it?
I think there are at least five offers out there.
Thank you.
Kim, you have a choice here of A or B. Since you're ahead, you have to go first.
Oh, let me try A again, please.
A it is. Everyone except Brett and Charles. Wilma is the world's laziest housewife. She hates scrubbing so much that last night she tried to vacuum her blank. Yes. All right, Kim. Wilma is the world's laziest housewife. She hates scrubbing so much that last night she tried to vacuum her blank.
Her toilet?
That would be difficult, wouldn't it?
There's no fixing them, is there?
Now, no matter what you say, you'll never please this audience. Say anything, Bob.
Anything.
All right. See? Well, some of them. All right.
Boy, if I thought I could get away that easy. Unfortunately, I said teeth.
Brushing her teeth. Vacuuming her teeth. Yes.
Cute. I like that.
Vacuumed
like
her teeth.
That,
yes.
Thank you.
That's adorable.
Thank you,
say, Miss Marjorie, honey.
Oh, is it me?
Yes.
Is it me? One scrubs one's toilet.
Aha!
Oh, thank you.
All right. What do you got there?
Moving right along with the wrong answers, she vacuumed her dog.
Her dog?
I'm on a good roll here. This is a good roll, I think.
Dogs love
not sure
to be
they went, what, somebody booed me and somebody ate me.
Some
it?
Booed and some ate.
Well,
they go both ways.
Right. Yeah, they go both ways. It's one of those audiences, you know.
All right. Marcia.
Gene.
Marcia.
Oh, Gene.
Marcia.
Wasn't it wonderful?
Yes.
Now, I'd have said toilet, but it's not tasteful, and God knows this is a tasteful show. So I said bathtub.
That's good.
Thank you.
All right. 3-1's the score. Phyllis, you need 2 to tie and 3 to win. Ready?
Okay.
Did you hear about the ugly Ulfria look-alike contest? I'll tell you about it. A blank one. Ugly Ulfria look-alike contest.
Kind of impossible.
It's one that we made up because we didn't want to offend anyone of the feminine gender.
Very smart.
I think it's about time.
No more ugly Edmund.
That's right. That's good. All out.
Ulfria, actually, isn't it?
Don't say it yet, Phyllis.
You waiting for me?
All right, here we go, Phyllis. It's about this ugly Ulfria look-alike contest. A blank one.
Gorilla.
All right. A gorilla, Bob.
Well, Brad, I think I'm going back to the small printing. I said a dog.
A dog. Good answer. All right, go.
Good enough for Phyllis.
Oh, well, Bob, as smart as a whip, cute as a button, clever, intelligent, witty, all of that dog.
Gotcha.
Brett's a former Miss World.
Really?
Miss Out of This World, Basset Hound.
A Basset Hound. All right, now you must match the remaining two. Marjorie and Bill to stay in the game and achieve a tie, Phyllis. What have you got?
This is up to the judges, but it's very close. Same family.
That's right.
Baboon.
That matches.
Yeah.
No!
Yeah.
Oh! Oh, judges!
Yay!
What do you have, Bill? I'm halfway. I had a monkey dog.
A monkey dog.
Where's
the monkey dog?
Monkey
dog.
Monkey
dog.
Monkey
dog. Monkey
dog. Monkey
dog. Monkey dog. Monkey dog. Now, Phyllis, we're going to roll you around, but we'll roll you back later for game number 2, all right?
Great.
All right. Say goodbye temporarily, and now we'll roll this message for you. Here we go. Time to say goodbye.
Goodbye.
And we hope all of you will join us tomorrow. Will you come back tomorrow?
Maybe and maybe not.
Listen, you going to get a little sleep tonight?
I'm fine.
You are? Good. You were nodding off there a little while ago,
really?
Charles. Yeah.
He wants, literally, this is the truth,
I might
America.
Be suffering from a strange illness and of all these years kept it from the audience and my people, my
really?
Public.
Parvovirus?
No, similar to that.
Oh, really?
Sleeping sickness.
No, what is it called now?
Aren't you glad you turned to me? You had 6 people, and you turned to me.
Yeah. Well, no, she keeps interrupting you. We were having an interesting colloquy here, but she keeps interrupting you. Now, what is this disease you're suffering from?
Nothing.
Car sickness.
Brettitis.
Oh, Brettitis. Oh, yeah, it's a terrible disease. Join us next time for the Match Game. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some of our contestants will receive elegantly styled watches by Jules Jurgensen, ladies' quartz analog with rectangular case, six diamonds, mesh bracelet, plus a gents' quartz analog day date and carat clad case with matching bracelets from Jules Jurgensen. And beautiful sweepstakes carpeting from Galaxy Carpet Mills features ankle-long nylon with Scotch Guard. Galaxy sweepstakes in 10 contemporary colors. And if you notice your nails lightly, buff them to a brilliant no-polish shine with Nail Buffs, the nail treatment for the whole family, the Nail Buff by Terrace of Springfield, Massachusetts. And from across the Pacific comes Hawaiian Tropic, natural tanning lotions and oils, plus this attractive Hawaiian Tropic inflatable rack. And there's a chore boy for every chore. Plastic puffs, clean casseroles, and no-stick surfaces without scratching. Chore Boy Plastic Puffs. More scour to you. Woodsonville Todman Productions. Program is edited for broadcast.